गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स।
गुड आफ्टरनून सर। हाँ
गुड आफ्टरनून। सो टुडे विल यूज द ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक रेशियोज टू फाइंड द एरिया ऑफ ट्राइंगल। So means we will be writing the area of triangle in terms of trigonometric ratios. So students, we have a triangle. And the triangle is A, B, C. So we call them the angle, this angle as angle A, this angle as angle B, and this angle as angle C, all capital letters. And we can also write, if we write simple A, capital A, it means it's an angle. So I can write angle A as A only, angle B as B only, and angle C as C only. Now it has three sides. So which three sides do we have, students?
सर ए बी बी सी एंड ए सी।
Yes. So the side opposite to angle C is small c. So the sides we write with small c, okay? Opposite to angle C. Now the side opposite to angle A, its length is small a. This length is small a. And the side opposite to angle B has length small b. Okay, so the three sides are A, length B, and length C. So these are small letters and these are capital letters. Okay, now how to find the area of this triangle? Now let us draw a perpendicular, because you know that area is equals to half into base into height. Okay, so as we know the base is C, but what is this height? What is this height? So we know that this is angle A, right? This angle A. So how to write the perpendicular? We know the hypotenuse also. The hypotenuse has length B. So we have a triangle. This height we need to find. Hypotenuse B. And this angle is angle A. So tell me, yes, this opposite side. So open Adam, open, hurry, hurry, Adam. So I need opposite side in terms of hypotenuse. Yes, yes, right. So opposite side is equals to hypotenuse sine theta. So this side will be equals to hypotenuse, that is B, sine. What is sine here? Sine A. So this height is your, so base is length C and height is B sine A. So you get the area as half BC sine A. So students, that is the area of a triangle. So this is written over here also. So area is equal to half into C is the base, and B sine A is your height. So this is B sine A. That's your height. Got it? So how do we learn it? See, we have these two sides and the angle containing this side. So take any two sides of the triangle. So this side has length, suppose B, this side has length C, and this is This side is, of course, this is A. So the angle opposed to it is A. So half into, take any two sides and the sine of angle between them. That is the area of triangle in terms of trigonometric ratio. Okay, so note it down, students. So we are doing four concepts today. This was the first concept, area of triangle. So note it down with complete understanding.
Sir,
yes.
Sir, वो जो angle B और angle C वाला है वो सर एक और बार समझा दो.
Yes.
ये जो सर आपने एंगल ए इक्वल टू एंगल ए बताया सर ये वाला एक और बार समझा दो सर.
बेटा ये आप जो है इस एंगल को कैसे लिखेंगे, यहां जो एंगल है सी ए एन लिखेंगे ना इसको, सी ए एन. व्हाट इज दिस एंगल,
एंगल ए
हाँ
एंगल सी ए एन और एन एंगल एन ए सी.
सी ए एन लिखो आप इसे, एन ए सी लिखो इसे, दैट इज द सेम थिंग दिस एंगल. या क्योंकि ए वर्टेक्स यहां पर इस पॉइंट पर सिर्फ एंगल ही सिर्फ एक बन रहा है तो आप इस एंगल ए भी बोल सकते हो. अब इस एंगल को आप एंगल एन नहीं बोल सकते, क्यों, क्योंकि यहां पर दो एंगल बन रहे हैं, एक इस तरफ एक इस तरफ, तो आपको सी एन ए या सी एन बी बोलना पड़ेगा. लेकिन अगर एंगल ही सिर्फ एक बन रहा है उस पॉइंट पर तो आप अकेला वो एंगल भी बोल सकते हो. तो आप एन ए सी बोलो, सी एन बोलो, या अकेला एंगल ए बोलो, सब का मीनिंग एक ही है.
ओके सर.
Return it down, students. So this area you can write it as that is equals to half. Suppose you are taking sides, you know the sides AB, then you will be writing the angle C between them. And if you are taking the sides A and C, then sine of angle B, which is between them. So this area you can write it this way or this way or this way. So if you are taking BC sides, then the product of the sides, length of the sides and sine of A, which is between them. If you are taking two sides AB, then sine of angle C between them. So it's the including angle, included angle. Okay, so take any two sides and the included angle between them. So the product of all three of them and half of it will be your area. I hope this is clear, students.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, please explain this statement, sir, with an example. So by taking a side. Right.
Okay. Note it down. I'm giving
yes, sir.
You the example also of this.
सर प्लीज क्लोज अप।
So we have, suppose we need to find the area of this triangle. So here you can see that two sides are given and the angle between them is given. So students, what will be the area of this triangle? Yes, half into product of the two sides, that is 11 into 15 and sine of 28 degree. Now how do you find the value of sine 28 degree? You can find it with the help of, you can on the Google also, so you have three ways to find the value of sine 28. You can find it from scientific calculator. So sine 28 is 0.27. So either find it from Google or from scientific calculator. In the exams, if this question comes, then value will be given to you. So this value will be given to you. So multiplying all three of them, you will get 38.7. What will be the units here, students?
Centimeter square.
See here, it is 11 centimeter multiply 15 centimeter. So 11 centimeter multiply centimeter is centimeter square. Okay. You have trigonometric tables also in which the values are given. So you have three ways trigonometric tables or scientific calculator, or you can directly find it on Google also. In the exam, value will be given to you, or the tables will be provided to you, or you will be allowed to use the calculator. So right now up to 12th, as the calculators are not allowed, so either the value will be, so log tables are also not allowed, so value will be given if this kind of question comes in exam. And if value is not given to you, then calculate it only up to this point. You can simply instead of 0.27, you can simply write sine 28 degree. So 15 into 11 is 165 divided by 2 sine 28 degree, and that's equals to 82.5 sine 28 degree centimeter square. So leave the value in this form only if you don't know the value. So students, here in this trigonometry, you are finding the area of non-right angle triangle. So of course we have used the trigonometry. Okay. Done, students? Shall we move forward?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So the next concept is sine rule. So that's our next concept. The sine rule. So again, so what is sine rule? Sine rule is like you have this triangle. So triangle will remain the same, students, in these questions. So this is A, B, C, triangle ABC, this is angle A, this angle B, and this angle C. So the side opposite to angle A is small a, the side opposite to angle B is small b, and the side opposite to angle C is small c. Now first thing we have written is that area of triangle, this triangle, is equals to half into, if you are taking the sides BC, AB, then the angle between them is C, sine C. If you are taking the sides AC, then half into AC and the angle B between them. If you are taking the side CA, then sine of angle, which is, so AC and CA is the same thing. So you can take CB, that's equals to sine A. Now the second thing is, I want to take this angle and side opposite to it, and another angle and side opposite to it. What is the relation between them? So I'm taking two sides, the relation between the two sides and the angles opposite to them, okay? Like this is the sine rule, sine A upon A is equals to sine B upon B. So these A, B, C are the lengths of the three sides, and this capital ABC are the angles, of course. Okay. So now if you divide this by half ABC, what do you get, students? Half AB is divided by half AB, so you get here sine C upon C. Half AC, so you get here sine B upon B, and half BC, so you get sine A upon B. So students, you need to be careful that here the length of the side you will be writing with small letters. So we have derived another relation. Got it,
sir?
Yes,
sir. Why we divide these ratios with the half ABC, all the ratios with half ABC?
To get this result. This is the result. I want the relation between See, I want the relation between two sides and angles opposite to them. I want this relation. So I've got this relation. Sine C upon C is equals to sine B upon B, or if you're writing it in terms of AB. So take two at a time. You can take these two at a time. So like B and A in terms of you want to write. So sine A upon A is equals to sine B upon B. You can also write it as A upon sine A is equals to B upon sine B. So we have divided them to remove the variables AB. So I want to remove. You have done these kind of questions dividing with some with the same number. So still the fractions will be equivalent fractions. If you have, suppose 2 multiply 8 equals to 4 multiply 4. Okay. Now if I divide them with 4, will the equality change? So still it's 2 multiply 2 equals to 4 multiply 1. So if you divide, an equation with the same number both sides, still the equation remains valid. So multiply, add, subtract, divide with the same number on both sides. So we have divided it intentionally so that I got this particular relation. You don't want to divide? Okay. Let us find another way, one more way to find this result. This is your triangle ABC, okay? Now, I told you that I want a relation between these two sides and the angles opposite to them. So I need an equation which has A, B, and angle A and angle B. Okay. So what is the relation? I want to find out the relation between them. Okay. Good.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Now this is the triangle that I have. So draw a perpendicular. Because of course I need to use trigonometric ratios. So trigonometric ratios can only be there when there is right angle triangle. So this side is A, this side is B, this angle A, this angle B, and let this height be H. So you have just written H is equals to, just written here that this H is equals to B sine A, isn't it? Yes. H equals to opposite side is equals to hypotenuse sine theta. Yes. So this suppose H you can assume, or you can assume it O also. You can even just make two triangles, these triangles COB, this is triangle COB and this is triangle AOC. So according to this triangle, what is the value of H? This angle A. So H is equals to B sine A. Yes?
Yes, sir.
And from this triangle, this is, what is H equals to?
A sine A.
A sine B. Yes?
Yes, sir.
Now equate both the equations. What do you get? B sine A is equals to A sine B. Or simply put the value of H over here. That's the same thing. So what do you get? This A will come this side. So sine A upon A, and B will come this side. Sine B upon B. Yes. And similarly, you can derive by taking this height and this height. So you can derive other relations also. Like sine B upon B is equals to sine C upon C. And you can find the relation sine C upon C is equals to sine A upon A. And writing all three of them together, and you get this relation back. So this is called the sine law. So either write S-I-N-E or simply write sine. So that's your choice. So this is the sine law, students. You want to do some question based on this law?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Find the length of the side AC. This is what you need to find. And we know the relation between the two sides and the angles opposite to them. So how will you write it, students? Which side is this? This is small c, and this side opposite to this is small b, right? So you want to find b.
Yes,
so start from b. Start from b. So b upon sine b is equals to c upon
sine c.
So B upon sine B is your sine 58 degrees. This equals to C, you know it's 12 centimeter, divided by sine C is your 39 degree. So you get B is equals to 12 centimeters into sine 58 degrees upon sine 39 degrees. So put the values of sine 58 and 39.
Sir?
Yes. So you get the answer 16.17. So find the values from the Google or scientific calculator and you will get this answer. Yes.
Sir, why you have reciprocal the formula? B upon me sine B, C upon me. Formula is sine B upon me B.
See, beta, that's your choice. You can write sine B upon B is equals to sine C upon C. But now,
okay,
you need to find this variable B. Yes? So
yes,
that
sir.
Is why you can take the B this side. Yes? And C this side. Right? And bring B this side. And bring sine C this side. So you can write it like this also.
Okay, sir.
But the point is, why I have written it over here, because variables I always write over here that I need to find, so that there will be less calculations. Because the variable that I want to find, I put that variable over here, because this is a variable that I want to find, so that it will remain in the numerator on the left hand side. So that's the way in trigonometry how to write the ratios. So it's better if you take this variable over here. That's a very good question. Yes, students. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So that was our sine rule, sine law, sine rule. So that's your choice. You write it this way or you write it sine C upon sine C is equals to B upon sine B is equals to A upon sine A. That's your choice. Shall we move forward?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So after sine rule, students, we have cosine rule also, isn't it? If there is some sine rule, then there should be cosine rule also. So students, what is this cosine rule? We use the cosine rule when we want to find the relation between the three sides and we know any one of the angles, any one of the angles, okay? So like, you know the three sides and one angle. So four variables are here. Okay. So either you know the three sides and angle A, you know the three sides and angle B, you know the three sides and angle C. So what is the relation between them? So as this is cos rule, so you can remember it, start writing from the angle that you know, and it's the cosine rule, okay? So start writing from here. Now what are the two sides which are not with A? Other than angle A, so other than side A, the two sides are B and C, okay? And then, so you will have this term B. So now this angle, write the square of this angle, that is equals to, now what are the two remaining sides? B square plus C square minus 2BC cosine. So that is the, if you have these variables. If you have these variables, then start with angle B and write cos B. And what are the remaining sides other than angle, other than side B? A and C. So now start with this B square. So here it was angle, here it is side. So B square is equals to what are the remaining two sides? A square plus C square minus. If you know this, then start right with cos C and then A and B. So two here, two is left. And now start with the C square. That's equals to A square plus B square minus 2AB cos C. So this was the way of how to write the cosine rule. Okay. So these are written over here. Is it okay, students?
Yes, sir.
Now let us derive this relation. So of course you have seen earlier also, if you want to derive the relations, you need to draw the perpendicular. Do you want to try it out, students? Draw the perpendicular. Yes? Yes.
Sir, to derive A square equals to B square plus C square, here are we using Pythagoras theorem?
Very good, student. Excellent. See, this is what you need to do in life, in physics and maths. You need to see what result I want. There can be, you know, n number of results can be found. So from this point, like you are in Kheda Khurd. So Where you want to go? You want to go to Kheda Kalam? You want to go to Pahladpur? You want to go to Nayabas? Where you want to go? What you want to prove? So where you want to reach? So I want to reach here. So I need these variables. I need variable A, variable B, and angle A. So I want the relation between them. Yes. This is the first thing I have noticed. Now the second thing I have noticed is that there are squares. A squares, B squares, C squares, side squares. So it means I will be using Pythagoras theorem. Yes, you are absolutely right. So students, just decide where you want to go. I want to go to Pahladpur, so I will move in this direction. If I want to go to Nayabas, then I will move in this direction. If I want to go to Kheda Kalam, then I will move in this direction. Yes. So things are given to you. You have six variables here in this triangle. A, B, and C. So in sine rule, you know the two sides, you know the relation between two sides, A, B, and the angle opposite to them. Right? Now I don't want two angles and two sides. Now the four variables that I want here is three sides and one of the angle, any one of the angle. Is this clear? So that's a very valid point that you people have raised here. So yes, we will be using Pythagoras theorem. Yes, very, very good. So students, draw perpendicular over here, let it be H. This is A, this is B, and this is, and the lengths are, length of this side is A. What is the length opposite to angle B? Length of this side? Small b?
Small b.
Small b.
And this is?
Small c.
Small c. So small c. So here if, because you need to use these triangles. So if suppose this part is x, what will this part be? This total is c?
C minus x.
So now try to derive this relation. Come on. Let me see how many of you can do it. So you have the hint, you know that B square is equals to H square plus, so you have two triangles, right? So start with Pythagoras theorem. So you have these two triangles over here. This is your first triangle and this is your second triangle, right? I'm just separating these triangles. C and this side, this can be O. Come on. So I've shown you the first step, students. Yes, now what will be the next step? A square is equal to h square plus c square plus x square minus 2cx. Yes. Do we need H, students, here? in our answer?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No. So we need to remove H, right? Do we need the term x square also?
No.
So h square plus x square, you can put b square that you need. So remove h square and x square, h square and x, h square plus x square, and bring here b square. Yes, you are very near to your answer, friends. This is what you are supposed to prove: a square is equals to b square plus c square minus 2bc cos a. So simply you have to put the value of x here. Yes. So what is x?
Cos a.
So this is your x, this is your h, and this is your b. So x is your base. So open Adam, open Hari Hari Adam, sine cos 10. So you want to find out adjacent side. So adjacent side is equal to hypotenuse cos theta. So this is your, this was your angle. This is angle A. You want to bring angle A here, and you want to remove X. So X equals to adjacent side is equals to hypotenuse is B, and cos theta is A. So put X is equals to B cos A. So what do you get, students? A square is equals to B square plus C square minus 2CB cos A. Right?
Yes.
So hence you have to have this relation, which is the cosine law. And similarly, you can draw the perpendiculars over here and here, and you can further derive the remaining two ways of writing the cosine law.
Sir, why we write x equal to b cos a?
Good question. Very good question, students. First rule. First rule. Maths, physics, economics, accounts, whichever subject you are studying. You have given variables. Always remember this rule: A, B, C, A, B, C. So only six variables were given to you. You have, for your help, for your way of solving the relations, you have assumed certain variables. Assumed variables. What are the assumed variables? You have assumed two variables. One is x and one is h. Now, you need to write the or find some value or some relation. So whenever you will be finding the value of, suppose, any of the angle or any of the side or the relation between them, it should be in the terms of given variable only. So all the variables that you have assumed by yourself, you have to remove them. Because all the students might have assumed different variables. Some might have used an x, some might have used taken y, some might have taken, you know, z. So you might have taken any variable. And instead of h here also, you can have assumed any variable. So whatever the variables you have assumed by yourself, you have to remove them. Always remember this rule. First thing. Second thing, if you are finding a relation, if something is needed that you need to prove it, so look at the proof. You were supposed to find that there are supposed to be three sides and any one of the angle between them. So of course, this I need angle and I need to remove x. So I need a relation between x and the angle. So what is the relation between x and angle? Because I want to get rid of x and I want to bring a. Students, agar aap itni si baat samajh gaye na, sirf jo ab discussion chal raha hai, समझ लीजिए आप मैथ्स फिजिक्स आपके लिए कुछ नहीं है फिर, वेरी इजी, दिस इज व्हाट यू नीड टू डू. गिवन वेरिएबल्स आर देयर, यू नीड टू प्रूव द रिलेशन बिटवीन देम. सो यू हैव एज्यूम्ड सम वेरिएबल्स बाय योरसेल्फ, सो द वेरिएबल्स दैट यू डोंट नीड एंड द वेरिएबल्स दैट यू नीड, फाइंड अ रिलेशन बिटवीन देम एंड देन यूज दैट रिलेशन एंड पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स ओवर हियर एंड यू get the variables that you need. You need B, yes. You need angle A, yes. You need them. Support it. So students, that is why, because these are simple, simple derivations. You will be doing 5 times more complex derivations in maths, physics. So these are very simple, simple things, but yes, through these simple, simple derivations, you are understanding which variable I need, which to remove, how to do this. So very valuable lesson, students. Yes. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Sir,
yes,
sir, we can also solve this question in this way. We put h square is equals to x b square minus x square, and here
see what I am telling you is, in the last question also I have told you 2 ways to derive a relation. Always you will find n number of ways to derive a relation. Aap nose ko kaise bhi pakad sakte ho. सो सिमिलरली, और जितने ज्यादा तरीके आपको पता होंगे उतना ही आपके लिए अच्छा है. ओके, वी आर रनिंग आउट ऑफ टाइम, सो लेट अस डू अ क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन दिस. ओके, सो वी नो द 3 sides एंड 1 angle, सो आई वॉन्ट टू फाइंड आउट दिस 3rd side नाउ. सो एंड यू नो द एंगल अपोजिट टू इट, सो ए स्क्वेयर इज इक्वल टू बी स्क्वेयर, सो दिस साइड इज योर बी, दिस साइड इज योर सी. So b square plus c square minus 2ab cos a. 2bc. So this bc cos a. So this a square is equals to what is b square? What is b? B is 13. 13 square plus what is c? C is 11 square minus 2 into what is b? B is your 13 and c is your 11, and then cos of 42 degree. Students, you solve it, and then this 2 will be removed, and this under the break, and you will find the answer. So that is C, yes, sine rule. 8.8 centimeter will be your answer. Yes, you want to apply sine rule? Do you have 2 angles? No. If you want to apply sine rule, sine A upon A is equals to sine B upon B. So you, the variables that you need are 2 angles and 2 sides. So you have 2 sides. Yes, you have 2 sides. You have 1 angle. So, but how can you find out? You know B, you know C, you know A. So here C is not needed and you want to find out A. So how, using this formula, how can you find out C? So A, B and A, this A you want to find out, but you don't have B here. Yes, that's a very good question, students. Got it?
Yes, sir.
It's a very good question. Students, questions are always good and questions are always welcome. But as I was telling you, we are running short of time. So this will be my last lecture of the basics of trigonometry. So students, 4th thing is that we have a parallelogram, and I want to find the length of the diagonal. Okay, so what is given to me? That's important point. This side is given to me. A, this side is given to me B, and this angle is given to me, let this angle be theta. So three, so you have to find out this length L. Okay, so you found out L in terms of A, B and theta. So what is the length of the diagonal of parallelogram? Yes. So students, of course, you have seen the sine law, cosine law. So if you want to write in terms of theta, definitely we are going to need a right angle triangle here. So let us draw a right angle triangle here. So this, I am completing this, drawing a perpendicular here this time. So this side is B, so this is also B. Students, what side is this? Open, Adam, open, hurry, hurry, Adam. Sine, cos, tan. So what is opposite side equals to? This angle is theta. This angle is also theta, right? Yes?
Yes, sir.
So what side is it? Opposite side. Hypotenuse sine theta. So B sine theta, this length. And what is this length, students? This is B cos theta. So now the triangle that you have got it is. So this is the L that you need to find. And this length is A plus B cos theta. And this length is B sine theta. So hypotenuse square is equals to perpendicular square plus base square. So L square will be equals to what is perpendicular? B square sine square theta. Yes. Plus what is base square? So squaring it, A plus B cos theta whole square, right? So what do you get? You get B square sine square theta plus A square plus B square cos square theta plus 2AB cos theta. Yes, right? And that is equals to, so you have B sine theta and B square cos square theta. So B square sine square theta plus B square cos square theta. So what do you get, students? B square is common.
B square.
So sine square theta plus cos square theta. And sine square theta plus cos square theta is 1. So that's B square, right? So I will write B square here. So B square plus A square plus 2AB cos theta. And this was L square, so square rooting both sides, you get this value. So student, that is the length of the diagonal in terms of the two sides and the angle between them. So what we have found, if this is length L, then L is equals to under the root A square plus B square plus 2AB and cos of angle between them. So see here, L square is equals to A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta. So you can write it in any way that you like. So students, these are three very, very crucial and very important results. And one was the area of triangle. So four things we have done today. And these lectures, okay. Unfortunately, this lecture I think is recorded or not. Let me see to it. Okay, it is recorded. Any problem, students? Yes?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay, no, thank sir. You so much. Now you can move on to your next class.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.